Find a comfortable seated position. Hips higher than the knees. This is why sometimes it's good to sit on top of a cushion or a block. Lengthen the spine, roll the shoulders back and down, close your eyes. Take a few breaths here to arrive onto your mat. It's already 12, half of our day already gone. Let's take a few moments here to just relax and disconnect from anything that we were doing. We will do Kapalabhati breathing as usual. For those that are not familiar with Kapalabhati, we inhale normally, allow the belly to blow up and get filled with air. And then we exhale, contract the abdomen. Inhale normally, exhale fast through the nostril, contract the abdomen. Belly fills, inhale, exhale through the nostril, contract the abdomen. We do it for 50 times. I will guide you through the beginning and then you can go at your own pace. Take a deep inhale. Exhale all the air out. And when you're ready, begin 50 times. When you're done, take a deep inhale. Hold your breath, tuck your chin to the chest, pull the abdomen in. And exhale, release. Take a few moments here to feel the effects of Kapalabhati breathing, a re-energizing pranayama. And then slowly open your eyes. Let's do our warm-up seated today, just to change it up a bit. Let's start with warming up our neck. Inhale, lift your chin up to the sky. Exhale, tuck your chin to the chest. Inhale, lift. Exhale, tuck the chin to the chest. You can keep going at your own rhythm, following your own breath. Exhale down. Look up to the sky and exhale. One more time, inhale. One more time, exhale. And then now start to rotate your head to one side for a few times, maybe three or four. And then on the other side for the same amount of times. Bring your chin back to your chest, lift your head up back to neutral. Let's exhale, bring the right ear close to your right shoulder, stretching our left side of the neck. Inhale back to center, exhale to the left. Inhale back to center, hands onto your shoulder, roll your shoulders to the front, bring the elbows forward. Maybe for 7-8 times. And then backwards, opening up our shoulders, our chest. Same for 7-8 times. Open up your arms and then rotate the forearms, warming up this way our elbows. And on the other side, a bit like a robot, extend the arm out, flex your hands, fingers pointing up. Exhale, make a fist and roll it down. And then flex the hands, extend the fingers, make a fist and roll it down. Starting to warm up our wrist. Really extend the fingers, don't go halfway, extend them. A few more times. I know our arms are getting tired. Last time, extend. Last time, fist, and then flip over the hands, palm facing up. Inhale, bring the hands up to the sky. Exhale, slowly lower your hands down. Inhale, both hands reach up to the sky. And exhale, close your eyes, float your finger down in front of your body. Last time, inhale, both hands reach up. And exhale, lower, floating the hands slowly down to your body. Hands onto your knees. Inhale, open up the chest, push the chest out. Exhale, round the back. Push the spine towards the back of the room. Inhale, open up, push the chest out. Exhale, round. Here too, you can follow your own breathing. Inhale, arch the back. And exhale, round. Seated cat-cow, starting to warming up our spine. A few more times. Last time, arch the back. Inhale. And exhale, back to central. This time, inhale, bring one hand onto the floor, the other one reaches up and above the head. Exhale, side bend onto one side. And then inhale, back to center, exhale. Bending onto the other side. Inhale, center. Exhale, bend. Maybe look up to the sky. Inhale, center. Exhale, bend. Let's go for a few more times on each side. One more time, to the right. And one more time to the left. Back to center. Shake your hands, relax your wrist. And then slowly we can start to remove our pillows and move ourselves into downward facing dog. Find your way into down dog. Let's go over the alignment. Hands as wide as the shoulder. Palm of the hand and fingers spreading onto the floor, pushing the floor away. Open up your armpit cavity. Roll the bicep in. Elbow, eye of your elbow pointing towards the front as much as possible. Push your seat bones and hips up to the sky. Your feet are as wide as your hips, toes spreading onto the floor. Maybe you want to keep your knees bent. Maybe you can extend the knees, but only extend the knees if you can keep your hips and your seat bones high, pointing up to the sky. Let's stay here for a few moments before we start our standing, our physical practice. Inhale, lift your heels up. Stretch the sole of your feet. Exhale, plant the heels towards the floor as much as possible. Inhale, lift. Exhale, push the heels down. Inhale, lift the heels. Exhale, push them down. Let's start to move all of our body. Inhale, lift the heel, roll your spine, and shift your weight onto the front plank. Exhale, bend the knees, push the hips up. Downward facing dog, press the heels onto the floor. Inhale, lift the heels, round the upper back, shift your weight to the front plank. Exhale, bend the knees, push the hips up. Downward facing dog. Fluid movements like a wave. Inhale, lift the heels, round the upper back, look in between your hands, plank. Exhale, bend the knees, push the hips up, down dog. Last time, inhale, lift the heels. Exhale, start to walk your feet towards your hands. Feet, hips width apart. Inhale, lift the chest and look up. Exhale, fall forward and down. Grab the opposite elbow. Hang in here for a few moments. Crown of the head parallel to the ground. Your knees might be slightly bent or maybe extended, depending on your flexibility. Just take your class every time, every pose, at your own level. The more you practice, the more you improve, and slowly you can. You will find out that you will be able to do things that maybe just a few weeks ago you were not able to do. Just always listen to your body. One more deep inhale. Bend your knees. Belly touching your thighs. And exhale, lift core and arm up to the sky. And then tuck in your tailbone. Flat back chair pose. Hold. Weight of your body spreading evenly onto the 2 feet. One more deep inhale. Exhale, release. Extend your legs, hands in front of your heart. Inhale, interlock your fingers. Push the palm of your hands out. Lift your arms up and above your head. Exhale, look to the ground and lift onto your tippy toes. Standing balance. Fall, it's okay to go back in. Straight line from your toes to your hands. One more deep inhale. Exhale, release. Lower your heels, hands in front of your heart. Let's start with our sun salutations. Inhale, both hands reach up. Exhale, fall forward and down. Inhale, lift the chest, look up. Exhale, step back into plank. Inhale in plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin onto the floor. Inhale, slide up into cobra. Exhale, tuck your toes, push the hips up, downward facing dog. Inhale, looking between your hands, step or jump to the front, lift the chest up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, both hands reach up to the sky. And exhale, hands to heart. One more time. Inhale, both hands reach up. Exhale, fall forward and down. Inhale, lift the chest, flat back. Exhale, step or jump back into plank. Inhale, in plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, slide up into cobra. Exhale, tuck the toes, push the hips up, downward facing dog. Inhale, look in between your hands, step to the front or jump to the front of the mat, lift the chest. Exhale, fold. Inhale, both hands reach up to the sky. And exhale, hands to heart. Last time, let's go. Inhale, both hands reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift the chest and look up. Exhale, step back into plank. Inhale in plank, exhale, knees, chest, chin, or bend the elbows, back, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, look in between your hands, step or jump to the front of the mat. Lift the chest. Exhale, fall forward. Inhale, both hands reach up to the sky. And exhale, hands to heart. Inhale. Both hands reach up. Exhale, fold forward and down. Inhale, lift the chest, look up. Exhale, step back into plank. Inhale in plank. Exhale, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Press the back of the feet onto the ground. Exhale, round the upper back, tiger. Hips as in a plank, straight line. From your toes to your upper back. Inhale, lower the knees, tuck your toes. Exhale, push the hips up, down dog, rest. Hold this downward facing dog. Remember the alignment. Hands as wide as your shoulders, fingers spreading onto the floor. Rotate the bicep in. Push the hips up to the sky. Maybe your knees are bent, or maybe keeping the hips pointing up to the sky, press the heels onto the floor. Don't let your ribcage drop, but bring it in. You want to become as thin as possible. Exhale, bring the ribcage in, belly button to the spine. One more deep inhale in here. And one more. Exhale. Inhale, lift the right leg up to the sky. Three-legged dog. Flex the right foot. Yes. One more deep inhale. Exhale, step the right foot in between your hands. Take your time to readjust your position. Bring the right knee on top of the right ankle. Only then, inhale, lift your core and arms up to the sky. Right knee on top of the right ankle. Right thigh parallel to the ground. Left leg extended. Both hands reach up. Bring the core in. Look to the front. Rounding towards your feet. Spread the toes open. Deep inhale. Exhale. Release both hands, framing the right foot. Drop the left knee onto the ground. You can stay here, opening up the chest, looking to the front. Or maybe bring your hand onto your knees. hips facing forward, knee in line with the hip and in line with your ankle, stay here. If you want to go a bit deeper, you can use your hands, place them on the lower back and really push yourself down. Allowing to sink deeper, we want to stretch our left hip flexor. One more deep inhale. Exhale, hands framing your right foot. Deep inhale in here. And exhale, extend the right knee, flex the right foot. Try to keep your back as flat as possible. Dynamic stretch, inhale, bend, low lunge. Exhale, extend, abs, up split. Inhale, bend, low lunge. Exhale, extend, up split, flex the right foot. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. A few more times. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. Last time, bend. Last time, extend. Now hold. The right foot is flexed. The right leg is extended. Square the hips, push. Pull the right hip back, push the left hip forward, flat back. See if maybe you want to grab a block and elevate your floor. We don't want to round like this. We want to open, just open. Open up your chest, look to the front. So maybe you need a block. You can choose the different height of the block. You know, this is the lowest. Then you can go up and up. See if you have blocks to help you with this. One more deep inhale. And exhale, slowly bend the right knee. Find your, lift the left knees up. Step back into plank. Drop the knees and sit down. Swing the legs to the front. Bend the left knee. Bring the left foot to the inside of the right thigh. Flex the right foot. The back is flat. Inhale, both hands reach up. Exhale, slowly fold forward, grabbing maybe our foot. Try to keep your back as straight as possible. Again, we don't want to round like this. Always opening up our chest. Hold, stretching our right leg. One more deep inhale. Exhale, release. Extend the left leg. Both feet are flexed. And then bend the right knee, grab the side of the right foot, and slowly extend the right leg out. Left foot extended, right foot, left foot flexed, right foot flexed as well. Try to keep your back straight. Again, we don't want this. When you do this, you don't feel anything under your leg. You want to be open. If this is too much, you can always grab a belt or anything long, an extension cord, your pants belt, towel, and then you can hold it this way with the belt. You can always find an alternative. One more deep inhale. Exhale, release. What we want to do now is to bring the right knee on top of the right shoulder. Place the right hand onto the mat, left one as well, and then pressing your left heel onto the ground, see if maybe you can lift your hips off the ground and maybe even your left leg off the ground. If you have the heel on the ground, it's fine. If you can lift it, great, hold. And release. Now, compass. Bring the left knee onto the floor. Sit onto your left hip. Right knee on top of the right shoulder. Maybe you want to use a belt, or maybe not. Grab the outside of the right foot with your left hand. Right hand onto the ground. Exhale. Start to extend the right leg up. Compass. Maybe you do need to use a belt. If that's the case, make a hoop into your belt, place it around your foot, and then you can use the belt and extend the leg, you know. You can let the leg go and use the belt to extend it. Hold it for a bit longer. One more deep inhale. Exhale, release. Last pose that you can try is another arm balance. Right elbow, right knee on top of the right shoulder. Right hand onto the floor. Left hand also along your body. The two hands are kind of on the same line. Then you hook the left foot on top of the right one. Squeeze the shoulder in between the two knees and start to shift the weight on top of your hands. Oh, sorry, Bagheera. And then extend the legs out. Once your legs are out, maybe you can bend the elbows and push the hips up. Eight angle pose. I go over again, you can, and I give you a few moments to try. Right knee on top of right shoulder, right hand onto the floor. Then you hook the left foot on top of the right foot, squeeze the right shoulder into the two knees, really squeeze, 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 and then slowly shift the weight onto your arm. Extend the leg. The more you extend the leg, the more you see you can lift the glutes and bend the elbows. Ooh, not easy. I give you maybe a few more seconds to try. And then let's find our way onto the mat. Knees under your hips, wrist under the shoulder. Inhale, lift the left hand up. Exhale, pass the left arm under the right one. Readjust. Right hand reaches up to the front of the mat. One more deep inhale. Exhale out. Inhale, right hand in front of your face. Exhale, come up into all four. And then tuck your toes and push the hips up into downward facing dog. A few breaths here in downward facing dog. Before we start onto the other side, inhale, lift the left leg up, flex the left foot, square the hips. Press the floor evenly with your two hands. Open up the shoulder, hips pointing towards the sky. One more inhale. Exhale, step the left foot in between your hands. Find your time, take your time to readjust your position. Left knee on top of the left ankle, only then inhale, lift your core and arms up. when we readjust the position with the left knee on top of the left ankle, we are much more stable in lifting our core and arms up. Extend the right knee, bring the hands up to the sky, lower the shoulder. You don't want to keep the shoulders next to your ear, lower them, create space. Hold. Strong Highland Warrior, grounding to the floor through our feet. Deep inhale. Exhale, hands framing our left foot. Drop the right knee. Anjaneyasana, low lunge. You can stay here, chest open, hands onto the floor. Or maybe bring your hands onto your left knee. Left knee in line with the hip, in line with the ankle. Open the chest. Sink deep onto your right hip flexor. This part of the leg stretching. Maybe bring your hands to your lower back and press your hips down, opening up your chest, increasing the stretch into your right hip flexor. One more deep inhale. Exhale, go deeper. Inhale, bring your hands to the outside of the left foot. And exhale, extend the left knee, lift the toes of the left foot up. Up, split. Fly back as much as possible. Inhale, bend the knee. Open the chest. Exhale, extend the left leg, up, split. Inhale, bend. Low lunge. Exhale, extend, up, split. Inhale, bend. Exhale, extend. A few more times. Inhale, bend the knee, low lunge. Open the chest up. Exhale, extend. Ardha Chandrasana, Ardha Hanumanasana. Inhale, low lunge. Exhale, last time, up split, hold. Left foot is flexed, right left leg is extended, left hip pushes back, right hip pushes forward, square hips, open the chest, lengthen the spine, flat back. We don't want to round, we want to open up. Maybe you need to use the blocks under your hands to help you create more space, to help you lengthen in the spine. Or maybe you can reach for the floor with your hands. Flat back. One more deep inhale. Exhale, bend the left knee, hands framing the left foot. Tuck the right toes, lift the right knee up. And then round the upper back, step back into plank. Knees onto the ground, sit back. Swing the legs forward. Feet together, knees together, flex the foot, both feet, and this time bring the right foot and place it in the inside of your left leg. Left foot is flexed, inhale, lengthen the spine, exhale, fall forward, grab your foot, maybe the ankle. You can, if you have a belt and you cannot reach for your foot, of course you can use it and help yourself. The important thing is that our back is flat. Hold. One more deep inhale. Go back to your breathing. And exhale, release. Bring the right leg to the front, flex both feet. And this time, keep the right heel onto the ground, the back of the right knee pressing to the floor, bend the left knee, grab the outside of your left foot. And then keeping your back straight, extend the left leg up. If this is too much of a stretch, you can always use your belt, whatever you're using instead of a belt, to lengthen the spine, keep the leg extended. Both feet are flexed. The moment we drop the right foot, we might lose balance. So both feet flexed, square the hips. One more deep inhale. Exhale, release. Variation of L-sit. Bring the left knee on top of your left shoulder, left hand onto the ground. Flex both feet, right hand onto the floor in line with the left one. Exhale, lift the hips up and maybe see if you can lift also the heel off the ground. Exhale, release. Good job. Compass onto the other side. This time we have the right knee onto the ground. Sit over your right hip. You can prepare the belt. Maybe you might need it. Bring the left knee on top of the left shoulder. Grab the outside of the left foot with your right hand. Left hand onto the ground. Extend the left leg up. See if maybe here you need to place the belt onto your left foot and grab the belt instead of the foot. Left hand onto the ground, extend. Maybe use a bit more of the belt and give yourself more space. Hold. One more deep inhale. And exhale, release. A tango pose onto the other side. So we bring the left knee on top of the left shoulder. Left hand onto the ground, fingers pointing to the front. Then we hook the left foot on top of the left one. Right hand in line with the left one. Squeeze the knees in. Once your knees are squeezing the shoulder, then start to move your weight onto your hands, extend the legs. And after you have the legs extended, see if maybe you can bend the elbows. When you bend the elbows, you see that your hips come up. Look to the front. And then release. Take a few moments to try. The key part to lifting your buttocks up is to squeeze the shoulder between the knees. The more you squeeze, the easier it is to lift your butt off the ground. Then you extend, and you will see that when you extend the legs, you naturally want to move forward and your butt naturally moves back up, and then you just have to bend the elbows. A few more moments to try. This is a difficult position, but it's good to start having the feeling of your body moving in different ways, of your hands starting to have a bit more weight on them. And then it's cool to do these kind of difficult things. Okay, release. Let's stretch our right arm. Find your way into all four. Knees under the hips, wrist under the shoulder. Inhale, right hand reaches up this time. Open up. Exhale, pass the right hand under the left arm. Extend the left arm to the front.
One more deep inhale. And exhale, release.
Right hand reaches the same level as the left one. Drop your chest and chin to the floor. Puppy pose, opening up the shoulders, opening up our chest. Deep inhale, exhale, press the palm onto the floor and slide your body onto the ground, elbows right under the shoulders, relax your legs, relax your buttocks, lift your chest up, lengthen the spine, chest open, shoulders back and down, sphinx. Let's hold this for a few breaths before we move into Cobra. Here you want to relax your glutes and relax your legs. In Cobra, in a minute, we want to engage them. Push your pelvis, the trugo, how to translate, yeah, pelvis, to the floor. Inhale, exhale, extend the elbow, press the hands onto the floor, and then slowly start to walk your hands closer to your hips. How much closer depends on your back flexibility, but what you want to do here is to really engage the glutes, you see, tighten the glutes, press the front part of your thigh onto the floor, and also the back of your feet onto the floor. Cobra. See if maybe you want to stay here, or if maybe you can walk your hands even closer, rotating. Look at, I'm not staying like this. I'm pushing my shoulder down, rotating the bicep, eye of the elbow pointing towards the front. Straight arm, look to the front. Really engage your glutes, engage your quads. Your quads are pushing onto the floor. Maybe you can even lift the thighs off the floor. Upward facing dog. But shoulders far away from your ears. Don't drop like this. We are actually lifting from our crown. It's our crown that is reaching towards the sky, lifting our legs off the ground. And exhale. Release. Bend your knees. And sit back into child pose. Knees together or knees apart. Sit back down, maybe. Bring your palms together. Short break. Try to sit down with your glutes onto your heels, which is still a bit difficult for me to do due to my knee injury. But if you can reach with the glutes for your heels, that would be best. One more deep inhale. And exhale, lift your chest, hands onto the floor, come back up into all four, and then sit onto the ground, swing the legs to the front. Extend the legs. Flex the feet, inhale, both hands reach up, exhale, fall forward and down. Full expression of Paschimottanasana, forward fold, even if you're around the back is okay. Try to really, with every inhale, lengthen the spine, go further, and with every exhale, try to pull your crown closer to your feet. Hold. If you cannot fold over with your belly and chest on top of your knees, you can keep the back flat and reach wherever you can. You can even bend your knees and give yourself a hug, stretching our lower back this way. You have different options that you can try. Take the one that suits you best. One more deep inhale. And exhale. Release. Hands to the back of the mat. Fingers pointing back. Bend the knees. Inhale. And exhale. Scoop the hips forward. Stretching our shoulders. No pressure onto our elbows. If you feel any pressure, try to micro bend them. Bringing them towards the back of the room, towards the ceiling. Relax your belly, relax your glutes. And exhale, release, bring the knees in, pull yourself up, bring your feet onto the floor, knees pointing up, back of your hand to the side of your body, place the elbow inside your knees and press the elbows together using your knees. Here too, don't sink within your shoulder, but try to open your chest and lift your chest up. We are almost at the end of our practice. And exhale, release. Last hip opening. You can keep your mat as it is here. I just want to show you in a way that there is space. Bring the knee on top of the mat and then maybe see if you have a blanket or a towel or something that slides. So I have this blanket, put it onto the floor, one knee onto the blanket, one knee onto my mat, and then slowly 90 degree angle in the ankle, in the knee and in the hips, slowly let the knee onto the towel slide open, opening up your hips. You can then maybe lower onto your elbows and stay in here for a few moments. Frog pose. If you can go deeper, feel free to go deeper and bring your chest onto the ground. We're just opening up our hips. A few more long breaths in here. Last deep inhale through your nose. Long exhale through your mouth. Inhale, slowly start to bring your hands onto the ground, lift your chest up, and exhale, slowly slide your knee back in. Get out of the pose. And then last two poses, twist, right knee onto the floor, left foot crosses over, left knee pointing up. Inhale, right hand reaches up to the sky, and exhale, hook the right elbow to the outside of the left knee, twist. You can stay here, or maybe you can see if you can grab your left foot with the right hand. Lengthen the spine, flat back, we don't want to round We want to open the chest. You want to twist. Every time you inhale, you lengthen the spine. Every time you exhale, you twist a bit more. One more deep inhale. And slowly exhale, release. Switch side, left knee onto the ground, right foot crosses over. Inhale, both hands reach up. Exhale, hook the left elbow to the outside of the right knee and twist. Maybe stay here or maybe see if you can grab the right foot with the left hand. Lengthen the spine, open up the chest, inhale. Exhale, twist more. Opening up your chest. One more deep inhale. And exhale, slowly release. Find a comfortable position onto your mat or on a pillow, onto a block, even just a blanket fold up is also enough to elevate a bit your hips. Lengthen the spine. Maybe if it's cold in your home, put your socks back on, your sweater back on. Open up your chest, roll the shoulders back and down. Take a few breaths here to feel the effects of today's practice onto your body and onto your mind. It was a hard practice today. Lots of arm strength, core strength. Let's do a few rounds of Samavriti box breathing. I will guide you through 4 or 5 rounds. Deep inhale. Exhale out. Inhale. 2, 3, hold the breath, 2, 3, exhale, 2, 3, hold the breath, 2, 3, inhale, 2, 3, hold the breath, 2, 3, exhale, 2, 3, hold the breath, 2, 3. Inhale, hold the breath, exhale, hold the breath, inhale, hold the breath, exhale, hold the breath. Inhale, hold the breath, exhale, hold the breath, inhale, hold the breath, exhale, hold the breath. And go back to your normal breathing. Now slowly move your attention to your heart space, the most central and deepest point into your chest. Start to visualize a point of light or a flower made of light deep into your heart space. Keep your mind and senses within this light. See the light. Feel the light. Listen to this light. Feel the connection of your deepest self with this light. If your mind gets distracted, that's okay. Acknowledge the distraction, but don't engage with it. Just bring your mind back to the light inside your heart space. With your next exhale, release the visualization and sit for a few moments in passive awareness, feeling the effects of today's practice onto your body and onto your mind. Now slowly open your eyes. And get ready for final relaxation, Shavasana. You can lay onto the ground. Extend your feet out. Allow your feet to open up naturally, hands opening with the palm onto the ground. If you still have the blanket you used before, you can use it to cover yourself up. And just relax. Allow your body to feel deep, heavy onto the ground. Relax your feet. Relax your knees. Relax your hips. Relax your lower back, your belly. Relax your upper back, your chest. Let the shoulder drop heavy onto the ground. Relax your arms, elbows, wrists, fingers. Relax your neck. Let go of any tension in your jaws, your lips, your cheekbones, the air behind your ears. Relax your forehead. Allow your body to sink deep onto the ground, heavy. Allow your breath becomes lighter. Just stay in here and relax.
Feel free to stay in Shavasana for a bit longer. Or if you're ready to come out of practice and finish with me, you can start to wiggle your toes and your fingers. Allow your breath to become deeper. Maybe lift one hand up and above your head and turn onto the side of the body. Take a few breaths here. Readjust. And then when you're ready, push yourself up to seated. Don't care about how you look, how your hair is. Bring your hands in front of your heart. Let's take one last long breath together. Deep inhale. Long exhale. Before you finish our, we finish our class, take a few moments here to think about three things that you are grateful for today. And then bow your head and thank yourself for today's practice. Our class finishes here. Thank you, everyone who came and joined us.